In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of post API request. If you have gone through our previous tutorial, we have implemented a network call with the help of a Dio library, and we have seen all the basic structure, all the basic code implementation. So I'm just making use of the same code and trying to make a post API call instead of a get API call, which we have done in our previous tutorial. So if you have not gone through our previous tutorial, I would suggest you to go through that particular tutorial because it will be very much helpful for you to understand this particular tutorial. And here in the postman, when we try to observe an API call here, so we are trying to make a get API call, and when you tap on the send button here, you will be observing a 200 OK as a status code. So this is the standard response for HTTP request, which states that our API call is success. And also there are different IDs for different API requests. For example, if we are trying to make a get API call, then 200 OK will be appeared in our status code here. If you try to observe the output when we try to make a fetch API call, here we are even getting this particular status code in our code. When we try to print the status code, we are getting 200 here, and below which we are getting the response for our get API call. So quickly get started with our post API implementation, and we'll try to see what are the steps to be taken for implementation of the post API call. So let's get started. So the very first thing we need to do is, like, we need to implement post here instead of get. So let's create a variable response equal to await do dot. We are having here various API request implementations, like we are having get, which we have done in our previous tutorial, and now I am using post here. So you can just make use of a post or post URI. Both the things will handle the post API request here. So I have added post here just as to cover the basic implementation. If you want to add post URI, then there is nothing much difference, just the way you specify the path. And now let us try to specify the path here. So the very important thing is, like, the APIs are categorized like for get API. To perform a get API request, so this is the URL here, and for making a post API request here, we need to add post, we need to append the URL with post here. So don't get confused here. Again, these are the creation of APIs which we are not concerned according to this particular tutorial. This is the API which we are making use to test our post API request. We have provided the first parameter, that is the URL, and now we can just consider removing the get API request here, add a comma here, and try to specify the parameters which you are trying to post. So add the parameters with the help of the data key here and specify them within the curly braces here in terms of key value pair. So the very first thing I would like to consider is name here, and specify name here. So I'm just specifying my name. And if you want to add one more parameter here, if you want to post one more parameter, so basically consider this is like you are trying to submit a form and save the details into your database. So I'm just specifying name and email as two different fields in the form, and let us specify the data accordingly. And again, here we have manually provided the data, but what I suggest you to try is, whenever you are trying to create or try to make use of this particular tutorial, then try to add two input text fields to your Flutter application and try to fetch the data from those input form fields and try to append the data in this particular key value pairs here and try to submit it, so that it will be very much helpful for you when you are trying to implement in a real-time implementation. According to the implementation for post API call, we have successfully done it. And now, before trying to implement this particular post API call, once try to test it in the postman. So let's try to copy this particular URL and try to paste it over here and try to make a post API call for this particular URL. And yes, this is a URL for get API call, and try to see whether this works. So here we can see we are clearly seeing a 404 status code. So 404 is like for not form. So whenever you are trying to see the status codes here, you are also trying to see a message to the right hand side of them. So it's 200, it's saying like, okay, so the API call is successful. And when the API call fails here, it is also showing the reason like not found, the requested resources could not be found, because this is the URL which is being used for get API request and not for the post API request. So what we need to do, instead of todos here, let's try to add posts here. And if you try to tap on send button now, then yes, this particular URL will work for sure, because we have not added any validations in this particular API creation. So it will automatically create some data for you, like empty data it will be creating. Let's try to add our parameters here. What we have considered, it's like name and email now. So let's go to the form data here and try to add a name here. And in the second field, let's try to add an email as key and value as abhi@mail.com. So let's try to copy this particular URL here and try to make a get API request for this particular URL. And here you can observe user ID is 1 and ID is also 1. But here if you scroll down a bit and try to observe the ID here, ID is incrementing like 2, 3, 4. And when you scroll down completely here, the last value is 100 here. And now let's try to make the API call, and I will try to explain you why we have made a get API request. So here we have made an API call and we have got ID 101 returned. So what is this ID 101 return? We have specified a name, email here as a parameter to our post API call, and we have got ID 101, and also what is the status code here? 201 we have got, and it is saying created. So just carefully observe here, the first time we make a get API request, we have got 200, okay. And when we try to make use of the same get API URL for post, we have got 404 not found. And now when we try to make a successful post API call, then we are getting 201 created. So here 201 is the status code whenever you try to make a post API request, and the message it is saying is like created. So what it is created? So the name and email ID are being added to our database. So we have created a resource. Okay. But when you try to make a get API request, you will not be getting this particular data, name and email here, because we are just using a third party free tool here. So this particular API is just for testing and it won't be saving all the data when you are posting it. But I'm sure this is the same scenario when you try to implement the post API call, and in your real-time APIs, as it will store the data. So whenever you try to make a get API call, that will be added to the existing list. Okay, so there is no doubt here. I'm 100% confident, because this is just a free tool. It won't be storing all the data which you try to post here. Okay, so that is why we are not getting when we try to make a get API call here. So this is how we can make the post API call here. And now let's get back to our code and try to test our code which we have written. So instead of fetch data, I would like to add here is like post data and try to run this particular code. So now let's try to tap on this particular button here and observe the output now. So here we have got the same output like Flutter 201. So what is the 201? Is the same status code. So here 201 is the status code which we have observed in the postman here, and also the response is 101 we have got. And here you can see in our code, we can clearly see our resource is being created. Like it is providing the name, email ID, and also the ID it has allotted for it. In Postman, we are not able to see it, but the same response we are trying to see in our code level. So I think you are now got a confidence, like our post API call is successfully implemented and we have even got the response here. And one more thing I would like to specify you here, like why is this response in this way? But at the time of API creation, the developers will try to provide what are all the required fields in the response. So we need not get the name, email, or whatever the things we pass in our post parameters, but they will consider what are the things to be returned to the user so that they can understand that the API call is made successful. Because if you try to pass a password here, you might think like the password will also be coming in the response. No, it's not the thing. So they will customize the response and try to send you so that you can understand that the resource is being created, that is the post API call is being implemented successfully. So this is it for this tutorial on the post API implementation. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And I would like to provide you the code in the description section below. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.